It's time for a change in music. You've heard all the pop songs. You've seen the Britney Spearses and the Justin Timberlakes of the world come and go. And now you're finally ready for something different. Well, my friends, if you're listening to this right now, you have found it. The Jason Bourne of radio, with a variety of styles and genres. A mixture of tracks in one place that is so diversified you will never hear it anywhere else. The reason you won't is because if you tell anyone about this program, you will be hunted down and disposed of.
Top secret sounds only on Spreaker.com. Shh! Don't tell anyone!
Hey, Lincoln! What's it?
Civil War with my beard. Now I'm here to whoop your ass. I bred up on your back. You cure cancer with your tears. Well, tell me, Josh, how come I never sat down and cried on your career? You're a washed-up has-been on TV selling total gems, and you're gonna lose this battle like you lost Return of the Dragon. I'll rip your chest hairs out, put them in my mouth. I'll squash you like I squash this out. I never told a lie, and I won't start now. You're a horse with a limp. I'll put you down.
This isn't Gettysburg, punk. I'd suggest retreating, for I invented rap music when my heart started beating. Chuck Norris doesn't battle, he just allows you to lose. My raps will blow your mind like a verbal John Wilkes
Booth. I've got my face on the side of a mountain, you voted for John McCain. I've got a bucket full of my head, and I'm about to make it rain. You block bullets with your beer, I catch up with my skull. I make fun of Walker, Texas Ranger, but I've never even seen that
show. I am Chuck fucking Norris. I've spread more blood and gore than 40 score of your puny civil wars, bitch. I split the union with a roundhouse kick. I wear a black belt on the beard that I grow on my dick. I attack sharks when I smell them bleed. I don't go swimming. Water just wants to be around me. My fists make the speed of light wish that it was faster. You may have freed the slaves, but Chuck is everyone's
master. Who won? Who's next? You decide.
Try for Keithy, see if he falls for it. Car crash Keithy, here we go, live on the radio.
Hello? Hello?
Bobby?
Hello?
Hey?
Hello?
What are you doing?
Who's this?
Keithy!
Keith?
Yeah?
No, Keith! No, Keith! No, Keith here! You call back later!
Where's Bobby at? Don't stop trying to act like you're Chinese.
Hello?
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 All right, I'll leave you alone. I'm sorry for bothering you.
Keithy! Keithy! Oh, he did! Oh, Keith! Keith! I feel, yeah, that's, you know.
All right, I'll just call you later. Oh, all right. Okay. Oh, you're going to talk Chinese?
At least you know what I was doing.
I can't wait to master, to digitally master this up and put the sound effects behind it.
I don't call back later.
All right. Are you mad at him? Because I'm waiting for that to happen. You haven't never been mad at Joe, no matter what.
Well,
Are you finally mad at them now?
No, I'm not mad at them.
Of course not. Of course not. Are you still a show belly?
No, Bobby's sister.
No, Keithy, I said we are live on air. Not we're not.
Oh, we are live on air?
Yeah, he said that would be embarrassing. No, we're live on air, buddy. We've been live on air.
Hey, how you gonna embarrass your little retarded cousin?
Aw, Keithy, you're not retarded. You're just a little slow.
Alright, Spring Breakers, you know what time it is. I'm gonna need all the hot girls to come up to the stage right now. Fellas, let me hear you make some noise! Spring Breakers!
Kings of the boss, he pounded on brewskis. Banging chicks right there in the sand. Bros before hoes and chicks with no clothes and slamming shots and marry a man.
Who wanna do a shot?
We do!
I'm gonna get fucked up!
Me too!
We came for a week, we the kings of the beach. Babe, water on the girls.
T-shirts, see-through! Cancun!
Party down!
Mother down!
Crack a brew,
marry a man. Pranks when you pass out, jokes about roofies, making girls kiss, marry a man. Giant sombrero, show us your titties. Creatine shakes, marry a man.
Spring break, y'all.
Oh shit,
I'm too fucked up.
Puke and rally,
that's what's up. Booze crew,
raise your glass.
Start that coke
off her ass.
Two chicks at the dance hall, take it to the dance stall. Trade these beads for their brains. Got girls jumping on a trampoline. Two men bound by the law.
Trash in motel rooms, clogging up toilets. Beer goggles if she's a hag. Planning the menu, picking out flowers. Nailing sluts and writing our vows. So happy, true love forever. Two kings walking hand in hand. Promise to cherish, trust, and respect him. Crushing pussy, marry a man.
We met last night at the club. You told me you were in love. Came home and smushed in the tub. And now you're in my yard. Woke up and saw you were gone. You're running across my lawn without your pants or shoes on. Here comes my Saint Bernard. Vodka was flowing, but cleavage was showing. Your mind, I was blowing. Man, we were so freaking wasted. Tag, you're my boyfriend. My name is Carl.
Look, I don't mean to be rude, but I don't think that we screwed.
I've got the pictures to prove it. Hey, don't look away. You're my one and only. That's what my doc told me. But don't think you own me. Now let's sacrifice some chickens. I've got some handcuffs. Feel free to spank me. But here's a safe word. It's call me maybe. Hey, this is my band. They seem to hate.
Really playing.
Crap, that's my husband. He's in the Navy. He's gonna kill you. He's also crazy.
I'm gonna kill you. Cause that's my lady. What's going on here?
He tried to rape me.
When people try to rape my wife, it makes me so mad. It makes me feel bad. I'm gonna kick your ass. Come to think of it, my wife is just a guy in drag. A real man.
This song sounds dramatic, but I'm bad at writing words. If you don't speak English, this probably sounds pretty good. You'd probably think I'm singing about some pretty serious stuff, but in reality I'm singing about the lack of stuff. I'm singing about these parts intense and emotional. As long as you don't understand it, your foreign grandma would love this song. Please send it to her, and she'll probably tell her foreign friends about the song her grandson or daughter sent her today. This song might hit the charts in her country if part sounded like Coldplay. If the chorus sounds like Coldplay, then I put some la-la-las in there. La 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 la, la 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 la. Hopefully a foreign grandma listens to the song every day, and if she asks you to translate the lyrics, here's what you say. A perfect translation does not exist. Well, at least not in your language. But if you must know, well, picture this: 50 billion rainbows, and the sun is setting, and the moon is setting also, and you're there in a gazebo. And then God descends from heaven, and he gives you $1 million. Take that feeling and put it into a song. I could translate word by word, but that'd take too long, and I've got stuff to do, Grandma. I don't have time for this. You gotta trust me, Grandma. This freaking song is brilliant.
You're listening to Top Secret Sounds on Spreaker.com.
What's going on?
If you tell anyone about this, I'll fucking kill you. I'm kidding. We'll come back by tonight. Okay, sweetheart.
Supper's ready. Come on, y'all. I've been slaving over this for hours.
Dear Lord, baby Jesus, or as our brothers to the south call you, Jesus, we thank you so much for this bountiful harvest of Domino's, KFC, and the always delicious Taco Bell. I just want to take time to say thank you for my family, my two beautiful, beautiful, handsome, striking sons, Walker and Texas Ranger, or TR, as we call them. And, of course, my red-hot smoking wife, Carly, who is a stone-cold fox, who, if you were to rate her ass on 100, it would easily be a 94. Also want to thank you for my best friend and teammate, Cal Naughton Jr., who's got my back no matter what.
Shake and bake.
Dear Lord, baby Jesus, we also thank you for my wife's father, Chip. We hope that you can use your baby Jesus powers to heal him and his horrible leg. And it smells terrible, and the dogs are always bothering with it. Dear tiny infant Jesus.
Hey, you know, sweetie, Jesus did grow up. You don't always have to call him baby. It's a bit odd and off-putting to pray to a baby.
Well, look, I like the Christmas Jesus best, and I'm saying grace. When you say grace, you can say it to grown-up Jesus or teenage Jesus or bearded Jesus or whoever you want.
You know what I want? I want you to do this grace good so that God will let us win tomorrow.
Dear tiny Jesus, your golden fleece diapers with your tiny little fat balled-up fist pawing.
He was a man. He had a beard.
Look, I like the baby version the best. Do you hear me? I win the races and I get the money.
Ricky, finish the damn grace.
I like to picture Jesus in a tuxedo t-shirt because it says, like, I want to be formal, right, but I'm here to party, too. Because I like to party, so I like my Jesus to party.
I like to picture Jesus as a ninja fighting off evil samurai.
I like to think of Jesus, like, with giant eagle's wings, yeah, and singing lead vocals for Lynyrd Skynyrd with, like, an angel band. And I'm in the front row, and I'm hammered drunk.
Hey, Cal, why don't you just shut up?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Dear 8-pound, 6-ounce, newborn infant Jesus, don't even know a word yet, just a little infant, so cuddly, but still omnipotent. We just thank you for all the races I've won and the $21.2 million. Woo!
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 Ow!
Love that money that I have accrued over this past season. Also, due to a binding endorsement contract that stipulates I mention Powerade at each grace, I just want to say that Powerade is delicious, and it cools you off on a hot summer day, and we look forward to Powerade's release
of Mystic Mountain Blueberry.
Mm.
Thank you for all your power and your grace, dear baby God. Amen.
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 Let's dig in.
That was a hell of a grace, man. You nailed that like a split hog.
I appreciate that. I'm not gonna lie to you. It felt good.
Dad, you made that grace your bitch.
Hey, boys, I want to see some napkins in the lap.
Boys, how was school today?
I threw a bunch of Grandpa Chip's war medals off the bridge.
That sounds like a good day. Texas Ranger, how about you?
Well, the teacher asked me what was the capital of North Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
I said Washington, D.C.
Bingo.
Nice.
She said, no, you're wrong. I said, you got a lumpy butt. She got mad at me and yelled at me, and I pissed in my pants. And I never did change my pee pants all day. I'm still sitting in my dirty pee pants.
So. I went to my bed until I was 19. There's no shame in that.
I get emotional. These guys are working so hard, and I'm just so proud of you. You remind me of me, precocious and full of wonderment.
I'll tell you what, Ricky, you are truly blessed. These two are two in a million.
I am.
Just like Carly's tatas.
You won't find another rack like that, I guarantee it.
Thank you, Cal.
That's real sweet of you, Cal.
Cal, that's a real nice sentence. That's about one of the nicest things you've ever said.
Well, I mean it.
Stopping will make me cry.
It comes from my heart.
Oh. Right.
I can't hold my tongue. These kids are my grandchildren, and you are raising them wrong. They are terrible boys.
Shut up, Chip, or I'll go ape shit on your ass. I'm going to scissor kick you in the back of the head.
Yeah.
Yeah. Turn up the heat.
Go on and get some, boys.
Come on.
I'm 10 years old, but I'll beat your ass.
Chip, I'm going to come at you like a spider monkey.
Like a spider monkey. Go on.
Chip, you brought this on, man.
Greatest Generation my ass. Tom Brokaw is a punk.
What is wrong with you?
Chip, I'm all jacked up on Mountain Dew.
I love that.
You gonna let your sons talk to their grandfather like that? I'm their elder.
I sure as hell am, Chip. I love the way they're talking to you. Because they're winners. Winners get to do what they want. Hell, you're just a bag of bones. Only thing you ever done with your life is make a hot daughter. That's it. That's it. That is it.
If we wanted us some wussies, we would have named them Dr. Quinn and Medicine Woman, okay?
I worked too hard for your bull, Chip.
Come here. It's hot. Come on.
Everyone just keep eating.
It's on. Come
All right.
I'll hold your hair.
And with me is a special guest, Car Crash Keithy.
What's happening?
Yay! Where you been, Keith?
All over.
I had her on mute.
I'm at Uncle Bella Show.
Uncle Bella Show. That's Bella such a good little show called Uncle Bella Show.
Damn it.
So, Keith wants to change.
Oh, man.
And get a different sound effect for him. We might get him an intro and everything. Because here's the thing, Keithy says it's the 7-year mark and he's worried about getting hit again, right, Keithy?
Yeah, we're getting low on funds.
Well, he said it was like every 7 years he winds up getting hit. You know, he's got hit by a car every 3 times. So within 21 years, if you do the math, if he's right about the 7-year mark, you know what I mean? That's 21 years worth of. And it actually kind of adds up because what's 7 times 4?
7 times 4.
Yeah, how
do you do? 7 to 14, so it's 28.
Yeah, 28. So actually, you're overdue, Keithy. I don't think it's exactly 7 years.
No, you got to figure because when I was 6 years old, when I was 10 or 11, and when I was 14.
All right, but you're 30 now, so it's like...
I'm past 30.
You're
I'm
past
35,
due.
35, but and 21. Oh, me bum.
Are you going to sit down? Where are you going?
I don't know. I'm stretching my legs. I can't sit down like you do.
Sit down for a minute, and we'll go play songs and stuff. Huh?
Who's touching your legs?
Nobody's touching no legs.
Where the hell is your head?
He's sitting next to me.
Leave it alone. It won't grow. I keep telling you.
Don't you got to go to work, Mark Fox? You've done enough damage.
Why?
You're a piece of shit.
I couldn't give a shit. I told you,
I'm not here. I'm not here to be liked.
I told you, not here draws flies unless you know somebody that eats it fast.
Car crash Keith, he's very mad at you for taking his friend away from him.
Well, I do apologize, but why, who's his friend? I didn't think that Big J had friends. I thought he had acquaintances.
No. Matter of fact, Keithy was in his prime argument. He said, for about yelling at you. He said, I never yelled at Car Crash Keithy, have I? I said, no, that's true.
I know.
He didn't yell at me because I'm gold.
That's right, you are gold, Keithy.
And I'm just some young fucking English dude who nobody fucking likes apart from Uncle Bobby.
I barely like you.
Nobody likes Uncle Bobby either, but what else is new?
Everybody loves me, Keithy. I'm a superstar.
Jen likes me, so I'm fine.
Who does? Joe.
Who?
Who?
Jen.
Oh, Jen? Jen likes everybody.
Jen's a sweetheart. Don't pick on Jen.
No, he's
not. I'm not picking on her.
I'm picking on her. He's telling you the truth. She likes him.
She just wants something. She just wants that little thing between your legs.
Jen? I don't think so.
She said she wanted a different flavor. She's tired of the normal.
She wants that UK taste.
Yeah. Just tell them it ain't yours. She swallowed.
She wants to taste the British penis. Oh, he's not British.
I am British. I'm English, not British.
Yeah.
I'm English, not British.
Well, Europeans are like Asians. Y'all look the same.
I ran a gay dude from New Jersey to where you live at, out that way somewhere.
You ran him where?
I made him run there because he's afraid I'm gonna kill him.
Why are you picking on gay dudes?
Why? Because he's a faggot.
So what, Keithy? You have not with gay people before.
Yes, I have gay friends, but.
Let's talk about gay marriage.
You know, and I was really gonna hate you. Mark's bisexual.
Uh-oh. Well, whether you're giving it or taking it, you're still gay.
I forgot you knew about that.
Yeah, he let the cat out of the bag.
You told me. I'm open about it. If anybody asks me, I will tell them.
Yeah, you told me on air, didn't you?
No, that was only a joke, but...
Oh, what, are you embarrassed about it?
I didn't think, not really. I don't remember it being confidential.
No, we weren't on air. And then you asked me about it on air, and I opened the answer.
Okay, that's what I thought. Alright. Made me feel bad for a second, like I let the cat out of the bag.
Yeah, he called the cops on me, so I went after him, and I scared the piss out of him.
Yeah, because you look real intimidating.
Yeah, I smashed his broad daylight 2 blocks from the police station with him sitting in it. In his car, I smashed his back window, I threw a rock at his head, and I made sure it hit it.
Cool. Sound a nice guy.
Yeah, Keith talks shit. He's the nicest kid I ever met. Harmless kid. He's trying to act badass.
Is he trying to show off?
Show off. Trying to act tough.
Yeah, the real part about it is I really did do that to the faggot. That's what's so funny about it. I told him, silly faggot, fix it.
Whoa, go fuck it to timeout. Go to timeout.
Did do it on
Are
purpose.
You fucking kidding me, dude? Stop it on the goddamn ground like that.
Are you really a fucking big fucking I'm not high.
Are you high?
No, I'm not. That's the problem.
Dude, he came here 7 o'clock in the morning. Wound up, it was almost eight. Walking around, talking all fast. I'm like, what the hell's wrong with you? Dude, I'm like, still in sleep. Bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. He's ready to go.
Oh, I got a text message.
That's why I'm making him entertain.
Got
fellas back there having a good time.
Oh, it's that bitch.
Which one?
The other half. Right, I'm going to work. I'm going to be in trouble because I'm already late.
Alright, go to work. Thanks, Mark Fox. We'll talk to you later. We're going to play a song anyway.
See you later.
Peace. Alright, Keith, anything you want to say before we get our break?
What is the matter hanging out with... what in the world made you trade up for a bisexual?
Come here. What?
What in the world made you trade up for a bisexual?
What do you mean?
I forgot about it. I just thought about it because you started talking about bashing gays. I didn't realize you had all these issues going on with you, Keithy.
I bashed that gay because he called the cops on me.
I didn't realize you hated gays and you hated blacks and... I thought you were a lot more open than this.
I've just gotten really mad lately and pissed the fuck off.
Yeah, you're an angry white man. What is your problem?
I guess it's a lack of nookie, I don't know.
You better tell your girl to get on and you're getting them...
Are you kidding me? She was so fucking mad at me Tuesday morning. She got mad at me because I turned around and told her to get off me because I had enough. Like, I slept with her Sunday night, Monday morning.
I hope this is coming in. Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Working.
I don't think it's working. Hello?
It ain't working.
It was working.
It was working, but now it ain't stopped.
All right, we're going to go back and listen to it. We'll be back right after this. I need a song or something.
Figure out how to use the fucking internet or get the fuck off of it. This is such bullshit. Here, take a look, assholes. Look at your fucking work. You suppose you'd like to share that with your friends, you little pussies? God, I'm sick and tired of this shit. I spend hours upon hours upon hours, but I'm not talking to you, so don't comment here. Get the fuck off the internet. You are of no use to anybody. Shut your fucking accounts down. Shut your fucking mouths. Fall in line and love socialist America, because that's what you got. You want to call me unhinged? I am. You'd be right. I am totally fucking unhinged right now. Fuck you, douchebags. Kiss my ass. You want to really do it? I'll give you my fucking address. Better yet, Google my goddamn name, find it yourself, and show up unannounced. I'll be happy to fucking greet you at my door. I'll be happy to find you in my bedroom in the middle of the night, you assholes. Come on over. I'll fucking kill you, and I'll enjoy doing it. You goddamn motherfuckers. You're too fucking stupid to live here. Go to hell, libertarians! Kiss my ass, you fucking bastard! You ignorant fucks! You may as well go to Canada! Here, go on, move up there! I'm a bitch! I swear, and I don't give a fuck who hears it! I'm really pissed off tonight. I don't have children. I live alone. I can spend all of my free time being online. And all of the hours that I've spent online. And you people don't even share the shit I post. Thumbs up. You'll write the comment section on Facebook. Well, you know what? That doesn't count on YouTube. Figure out how to use the fucking internet or get the hell off of it. God all fucking mighty. I am so sick and tired of this shit. And you people that just think you have it all figured out. Wouldn't surprise me one damn bit. Stop it. Either act like a goddamn adult and join us, or go the hell away and be done with it.
Just sitting at home thinking about doing a show, so I Skype you. See, just a plain phone call. Well, that just wasn't enough, so I
I Skype you.
Skype you.
If I was funny, well, I wouldn't be none of you. Well, ain't that the truth?
Ain't that the truth?
So if you don't answer, well, I hope you'll get cancer. Till then, I'll just I Skype you. Skype you.
All right. Skype you now. Here's the problem with it, though. I want to call my sister Kelly, but I really can't because I don't have her number. I thought I did, but I don't. So, she put in there, what are we going to talk about? I'm bored. So listen, I don't know. Oh, here, what's this? Who's Sky Jones? One mutual friend. All right, Sky Jones, I'll let you in. You know? Could be someone undercover trying to spy on me. Someone who I deleted, but you know. Well, if that's the case, and if that is the fact, and they are somebody who I'm no longer friends with, and they're spying on me, and it'll come to light. The crazy will come out of them, and then I'll just block them. So, this is Sky Jones. Woo! LOL, who's this? Sky Jones goes, woof, woof. Oh, woof, woof, it's a dog. I'm an idiot. Oh, it's Mark. What a dick. Hit my deuce guy. So where's your old Facebook? Why you got a new goddamn... Why are you making new Facebooks like a creep? What is wrong with you? Alright, I don't know if she's gonna call, but I think she might have pussied out. I don't know what's going on. I took the headphones off. We're waiting to talk to my sister Kelly. If not, we'll call Mark. He might not answer though. Call Mark and figure this out. Let me hit my deuce guy, good guy. Whatever, dude. Does he know I'm on a fucking show? What am I doing now? I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm trying to find. This is a fucking mess now. I got so confused with the. Oh yeah, Skype. I want Skype. Let's see. I don't even think I have Kelly on here. It's called Dickhead.
Waterworld.com.
I'm just a dumb redhead ginger. You better run. I want your soul. I'm just a pale freckled ginger. I came from hell. My blood is cold. I have no soul.
No one will have sex with them. They come out at night, they creep and crawl. Who does God hate most of all? Gingers. Who should have never been born? Gingers. Who's adopted? Gingers. Who belongs with floating turds in the fucking toilet bowl? Gingers. Gingers are leprechauns. Evil Irish little drunks. They should all be killed at once. Kill them and collect insurance. But they're already fucking dead. Skin is white, hair is red. They like giving head to men in bed. It's gay.
I'm just a drunk with a temper. Has anyone seen me Lucky Charms? I'm just some scum from the shitter. My hair is red. It's fucking wrong. I'm just a dumb,
I'm just a dumb
redhead ginger.
You better run.
I want your soul.
I want your soul.
I'm just a pale freckled ginger. I came from hell.
suck my balls. Evil gingers like Harry Top. I hate him the most. I'm just a dumb.
I'm just a dumb.
Redhead ginger. You better run.
Better run.
I want your soul.
I want your soul.
I'm just a pale. Freckled ginger. I came from hell. My blood is cold. I have no soul.
Ginger, for he beeth a nasty daywalking vampire who stealeth your soul. For don't you know it, the ginger gaineth a freckle for every soul he taketh.
What is world.com.
This song sounds dramatic, but I'm bad at writing words. If you don't speak English, this probably sounds pretty good. You'd probably think I'm singing about some pretty serious stuff. But in reality, I'm singing about the lack of stuff. I'm singing about these parts intense and emotional. As long as you don't understand it, your foreign grammar would love this song. Please send it to her, and she'll probably tell her foreign friends about the song her grandson or daughter sent her today. This song might hit the charts in her country if part sounded like Coldplay. If the chorus sounds like Coldplay, then I put some la-la-las in there. La 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 la. Hopefully your foreign grandma listens to the song every day. And if she asks you to translate the lyrics, here's what you say. A perfect translation does not exist. Well, at least not in your language. But if you must know, well, picture this. 50 billion rainbows and the sun is setting and the moon is setting also, and you're there in a gazebo. And then God descends from heaven and he gives you $1 million. Take that feeling and put it into a song. I could translate word by word, but that'd take too long. And I've got stuff to do, Grandma. I don't have time for this. You gotta trust me, Grandma. This freaking song is brilliant.
Subscribe.
If the chorus sounds like Coldplay.
Whoa. Free boat ride for three.
Now, who should I take? Keeve?
Yes.
And T-Pain.
Cool.
Shit! Get your towels ready, it's about to go down! Everybody in the place hit the fucking deck! But stay on your motherfucking toes! We running this, let's go!
I'm on a boat! I'm on a boat! Everybody look at me, cause I'm sailing on a boat! I'm on a boat! I'm on a boat! Take a good hard look at the motherfucking boat!
I'm on a boat, motherfucker, take a look at me! Straight floating on a boat! Bustin' five knots, wind whipping out my coat. You can't stop me, motherfucker, cause I'm on a boat.
Picture drink, I'm on a boat, bitch. We drinking Santana champ, cause it's so crisp. I got my swim trunks and my flippin' floppies. I'm flipping burgers, you at Kinko straight flipping cabbage.
I'm riding on a dolphin, doing flips and shit. The dolphin splashing, getting everybody all wet. But this ain't SeaWorld. This is real as it gets. I'm on a boat, motherfucker, don't you ever forget.
I'm on a boat, and it's going fast, and I got a nautical theme, patch me the Afghan. I'm the king of the world, on a boat like Leo. If you own the show, then you show not me, oh.
Get the fuck
You were never here.
You didn't see anything.
ever felt left out of the group, excluded, given the boot when you knew you should have been a shoo-in? Like some AJ Druid was pursuing to ruin your life with a curse, but worse, he brought his whole damn crew in. And now it's high noon and you're a target to shoot in. His school's a battlefield, no wonder you're truant. They always look at you and they boo at what you're doing, and you go off like a bomb at the Olympics in Munich. Nah, you're just an extraterrestrial, less than respectable. You'll never get to get the girl. You're just a jester at the festival, I guess it's acceptable to peg your head with vegetables and kick you in the testicles, and best of all, let you know that you're a filthy dog and you'll never be best in show. So why the abuse? Cause all a bully needs is a fucking excuse.
Planet Earth, I need a friend, cause I'm on the outside looking in. I'm an alien, I'm just an alien. Feeling lost but never found, till I find myself being pushed around. I'm an alien, yes I'm an alien. I'm an alien.
I'ma be honest, it gets better, I promise. So don't let them ground you down to a pound of sawdust. Stay on stage the longest till the gong hits and everybody comments on their fondness of your polish and your overall knowledge. Remain calmest and abolish your modesty, cause honestly, you gotta be positive, you're a prodigy. And show the world that you're not one to mess with. It's a broken home that makes these bastards aggressive. You can expect to get rejected, neglected, stripped naked, and tested until they reckon. You feel terrible, cause nothing is comparable. Violence ain't the answer, but the pain is unbearable. You're nice and jaded from being isolated, now you coast through life feeling twice as hated. So why the abuse? Cause all a bully needs is a fucking excuse.
Planet Earth, I need a friend, cause I'm on the outside looking in. I'm an alien, I'm just an alien. Feeling lost but never found, till I find myself being pushed around. I'm an alien, yes I'm an alien.
On the drums.
Of the DJs on these particular programs have been changed to protect the stupid, and is loosely based on a sort of kind of but not really true story about people who may or may not exist. Thank you and stay safe, Spriggers. Last time on the Witness Protection Program.
Big money!
Big money, no whammy.
Yeah, absolutely. Welcome to the Witness Protection Program. I am your hobbyist, Billy Mofford, and with me is the infamous Pimp Vader. Or Pimp Vader is next to Joe. I don't know. I get confused which way he goes with it.
Shut up, Bobby. It's Angry Bob.
There you go.
Sorry, man. Apologies.
All right.
He said hi, Bobby. What do you want from
him? Hi, Pimp Vader. I missed you so much.
Yeah, he knows that's not true.
That is. I listen. I look at him in his black suit.
Bobby.
I just get turned on. You never know what's under that thing. You know what I mean? That's the funny part.
Big fucking cock.
And now, your two number one hobbyists, Billy Mofford and Angry Bong.
Now, who we got today? C3PPO?
No, R2D2.
R2D2 again.
The drug dealer droid.
And speaking of the drug, I wish I could have prepared for this, but I think Joe's prepared anyway. He hangs out with all them guys. I think we're talking about Star Wars.
Well, because that would be a copyright infringement. What we're talking about is more stars.
I think you're taking it a little too far. I don't think talking about something is infringement.
Just a second. Well, what do you think, R2?
Oh, yeah, because he's an expert. R2, are you there?
Yeah, he responded.
What did he say? Because I didn't hear nothing.
He basically told you two to go fuck yourself, and I agreed with what I said.
Well, we actually have. I think it could be a good show. I mean, we're usually at our best when we freestyle anyway. And we've got a little things up in the thrown out there. We got the Star Wars topic. We got another topic coming up when we do the movie review. This topic is. It was interesting. I came in and they were into it. And I started getting into it immediately, talking about, Joe was stating how the, what do they call the guys in the white in Star Wars, the bad guys? Hello? Now no one's gonna feed it, you motherfuckers.
What
are they called? The white people, the people in the white.
Stormtroopers.
Yeah, so...
Can you take it down a notch there, sister?
No. Listen. Because I'm trying... You guys were just saying who they were. I say something, no one says nothing. And I don't know if you're fucking with me or you're just smoking dope.
I smoke a lot of dope.
So, Joe was saying how the stormtroopers... or Pip Vader was saying how his stormtroopers... Where, they weren't really that good because they lost to, like, all these people, like, they lost to the Ewoks and stuff. And that was funny, but what I was saying was, the Ewoks had help, you know. They had the Jedis, and they had the big fucking Chewie guys. They had more of them. When I watched the whole, there was a whole movie about the Wookiees. Or not about the Wookiees. About the witch cars. It was all about the, not the Wookiees, the
Ewoks.
The Ewoks. But the Wookiees were in it. They helped fight in the Ewok village. When those big fucking, what are they called, Joe? Don't you got the sound of, don't you have one? I mean, curtain pull back. Don't you have one of those things in your room? In your studios? And those big white monster walkers. Where'd he go?
Is that you making that sound effect?
I had Tourette's and I do that every now and again for no reason.
But you'll die.
Stop.
That's R2D2. He's all drunk. He's all drunk and whacked out.
Look on you with my own eyes.
Apparently he's all whacked out on the microphone.
I don't know what he's doing. I think he has to go. So I think he has to go in another room to do these sound effects. I feel like he's like, hold on, Bobby. He goes in another room. Basically, like the sound effect. He can't talk and do the sound effect. I don't know what to do. Joe? He's doing the mess with me.
Oh, man.
R2D2's.
What is that thing?
What do you think about that?
fucker. No, he's not talking. Did he hang up?
Yeah, it is. Like George Lucas is some big genius. He just kept using the same names and reversing them for fuck's sake.
Listen, that is a genius. That's ingenious. Get reversed. It's the opposite of... I love it. Except for it was totally opposite. They wouldn't be hairy. They'd be like bald, little things.
You're those kids. People have to blame you. We are the Ewok.
That doesn't help me spell Ewok looking backwards. That's confusing.
E-W-O-K-E-S.
That's not right. Oh, why do I have an I in here?
I got a salmon. Wait, what? Isn't there a salmon?
Mommy. Yes. Damn, Wookiee. What the hell's going on?
I can't get back to what I was saying before Bobby decided he would rewrite the Star Wars franchise.
I'm not! I'm telling you, there's an Ewok movie. It's separate from the other movies.
I've been saying that. We're not talking about the fucking whatever it is you watched in some second morning. We're talking about the Star Wars. There were six of them. And there's only one Star Wars movie that has fucking Ewoks in it, and that is Return of the Jedi.
Okay, and they still had all that people fighting with them.
They had, then there was one Wookiee, and that was Chewie.
Okay.
Han Solo was there. Princess Leia. We're all down on the planet, right? And Luke went up to the... got captured and went up to the spaceship, and that's where him and Vader had their last battle. And the Emperor tried to convert him. And then Leia and fucking Han and them got the fucking Ewoks to help them attack the fucking... the shield generator that was... protected the Death Star, right? And the big fucking fight out in the jungle there, out in the woods. They beat, well, they weren't imperial snowwalkers, they were just the two-legged ones. They crushed one of them with fucking logs and tripped another one with logs. And again, very practical vehicle if you're gonna go to a swampy forested area. Something that's top heavy, tall, and
like, yeah.
You know what I mean?
No, I think it kind of makes sense. If you had really, really long legs, you could walk in the swamp. Right?
Yeah, well, see, Bobby, think about walking on the swamp, walking in the snow. It doesn't really hold your weight from weight distribution.
And so you think these things...
No, but they tell you if somebody breaks through the ice, to lay down on the ice and try to reach them. You're spreading your weight out over more area. So, something that's, say, again, 2 feet, made of steel, tall and top heavy, would sink into the soft soil and swampy soil of the forest, yeah.
Help me. So, you don't think that would be, it would get stuck?
I think a track vehicle probably would have made more sense. Nothing.
Well, I mean, some of the vehicles floated, so that was.
I made this point the other day in my show. My favorite movie of all is The Empire Strikes Back. And at the start of it, they have the big snow battle. Okay? So, here's the Imperial fleet, you know, the most powerful fucking force in the universe. Finally tracks down the rebels on this ice planet of Hoth. They have to send down a big ground invasion to knock out the shield generators to get in the base. So, what does this big battle cruiser fleet have for its ground invasion? Five Imperial walkers, which are, like, by all logs look like they're about 10 stories high, would weigh hundreds of tons each, and they walk on four legs. Not a very practical design of mechanically or practical, you know, in any aspect.
No, but they're cool. Movie magic isn't about practical. That's why they call it movie magic.
Yeah. You know?
The snow speeders. They just happened to have toes. What the fuck would that thing be doing? Great. They fly around like they're quite fast, you know? They, what do they know? And have tow cables on them. Not just a tow cable. Tow cable is like hundreds of meters long.
Yeah, I don't see anything ever, even when we start, we're starting to get things afloat and fly.
Yeah.
I don't see those things automatically right away being capable of towing. Never really.
How would you tow a ship that won't fly? Most snow speeders aren't like a glider that can't go here.
Well, if they get out in there in space, then they can tow something. They don't have
wings or anything for lift. So up in space they can tow, but like down on a planet where there's obviously an atmosphere like Earth because everybody was running around with a space suit on. It's just really cold. Something of that shape obviously wasn't getting lift. It would be like a magnetic, anti-magnetic fucking gravity thing, obviously. Because
you also have to remember that this was the first Star Wars was in, like, what, the 60s? Early 70s?
1977, Bobby.
Yeah. So, you know.
Like, motherfucker, tread lightly.
I'm just saying,
You're listening to the Witness Protection Program and or Top Secret Sam. Two radio shows that are so underground that even the government don't know anything about it, or do they?
FBI to DEA, testing on Houston Command. How do you read this?
This is Houston DEA, I read you loud and clear on command.
10-4.
Tune in to find out, only on Spreaker.com.
Your own. What's with your voice? I can't freaking tell. You sound like
Barney.
Having sex for the speaking spell. I'll school you anywhere, MIT to Oxford. Or your fans will be like, that was awkward. I'm as dope as two rappers, you better be scared. Cause that means Albert E equals MC squared.
You've got no idea what you're messing with here, boy. I've got 12-inch rims on my chair, that's how I roll.
Face it, black coffee is manly. Do you think Clint Eastwood ever ordered a cream and two sugars? Of course not. Do you know why? Because Clint Eastwood was a man, and the girls love manliness. Once, at a Denny's, I encountered a waitress who changed me forever. Jenny. Such a lovely girl. I had to show her my manliness, or at least act the part. So, I ordered a lumberjack slam, extra ham, piece of carrot cake, and of course, the clincher, black coffee. I'm impressed with the manliness of breakfast, which would have wowed most waiting persons. Jenny tried to break me. by bringing more and more coffee. Oh, I down my breakfast long before my family finished their 3 pancakes, mind you. But that coffee. I couldn't back down now. I'd come too far to chicken out. With that, she brought the check and topped me off. My 11th cup. I tried to manage it down, but I was on my last leg long before my bump. When no one was looking, I dumped it in my grandmother's cup, mock-sipped it, slammed it down, and strode the door victorious. Oh, I still take my coffee black, for the same reason guys do anything. To impress women.
Solo, but I sprained my wrist. list. I'm proud to tell you that I cried while watching Schindler's List.
We're only moderately rock and roll.
Out to a stage dive, the floor is covered in grits.
And not smashed my guitar, but it cost me quite a bit.
Yeah, I will sign your photo, but I draw the line at tit.
We're only moderately rockin', moderately rockin'. 40% rock and roll.
And 10% troll.
This is the worst sport ever.
I gotta come from behind.
So what?
Bye now. You're a choker, Mike. We both know it.
Now there's a plan.
This is inane.
It's nap time, kids.
Hot streak. I feel kind of weird.
Where the fuck is this?
Didn't even put up a fight.
Have fun.
Oh, you're shitting me.
I feel like someone's shitting in my ear.
Reloading, you asshole.
Sleep tight.
You're getting hot. I'm hot. I might take off some layers.
I see the void.
Pride before the fall. Just saying.
Let's go.
Come on, people.
Hello, mother.
Petroleum.
You got some game in there somewhere?
Fuck. No change.
It ain't my face. I dare ya.
Well, that was a statement of intent.
Ain't this a party? Two girls, one creepy old man.
I'm breaking. They ain't after us.
This station is the oral equivalent of a glass enema.
Oh, Neil, my buggity fuck. Would you look where you're driving?
Written by an imbecile.
Ah, sorry, dog.
Oh, man.
Exercise is awful for you.
Oh, who's your creepy uncle now?
Wow, thought I was crazy.
Hurry the fuck up, men in uniform.
You gave me a reason to keep on living.
I can't right now.
Some other time.
I hate all of you.
Have you got the stones to finish this?
Man, I'm kind of hungry.
Ah, shit.
Where the fuck is this?
The cops! How many of them are there?
Keep your head down!
I need to take better care of myself.
Oh, you are such a dick!
You know, he might shoot you even if you give it to him.
Slow down.
We're having fun! We're having fun!
I'm really tempted to do something unpleasant right now.
Out of bullets! Let's have some sophisticated fun!
See you later!
Whoa.
Oh, what's going on?
Me and Andy have some questions to ask you, Bill Crawford.
You're already telling them against me. Andy, I will let you ride my rides for free with any with cotton candy, soda, whatever, whatever you want.
I don't know why, Andy, because he's cornered, but we know that he would take it home to his real kids. But that's what them carnies do. They take your cotton candy and they take your shit. And then they're, oh, well, we don't know where it's at. And then all of a sudden it ends up at home with their kids.
I love that they're wearing, yeah. And maybe I can have some fun being a carny for a day. Have some fun.
Oh, yeah. I'll let you run the ride, buddy. I'll let you do whatever you want. You can throw popcorn at the other customers.
Putting the elephant shit up in the elephant cage.
We'll shoot you out of a cannon. It'll be great.
The Andy Bark Show live at the Delaware County Fair.
There you go. I like it.
Oh, Sonny, you're going to see. And
that sounds like fun. It does sound like a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah. Jeez, sign me up. The funny thing is, we have a carnival that comes to our neck of the woods every single year in O'Connor Falls. And
I'm there, Andy. That's me. I'm there.
In O'Connor Falls, Wisconsin?
Sure.
Seriously, you go to O'Connor, you come to Wisconsin?
No, we don't go that far.
He's the guy that runs the fair as well.
Oh, he's a stalker!
What? No, I don't run the fair as well. I run the kiddie rides. You still run the kiddie rides, Andy?
Those things are fun!
He rubs the glory hole, Andy.
The glory hole.
This station is the oral equivalent of a glass enema.